Good morning, students. Welcome to the biology class. We are going to continue with the second part of this chapter, that is immunity. In our previous class, we discussed about the acquired immunity and its unique features. And today we are going to start with the cells of immune system. Cells of immune system. The very important and the main cells of the immune system, they are the lymphocytes. Lymphocytes, they are the part of the WBCs. Immune response are produced by two types of lymphocytes, that is B lymphocytes and T lymphocytes. Lymphocytes, these arise from the stem cells present in the liver in the fetus and in bone marrow in the adult. But their maturation and the processing takes place in lymph gland, hence the name is lymphocyte. And depending upon the gland associated with their maturation, their processing, they are of two types, B cells and T cells. So first we will discuss about the B lymphocytes or the B cells. Those stem cells of bone marrow which transport in liver during the embryo stage and in bone marrow after the birth, these cells mature to form the cells called as the B lymphocytes or B cells. So B lymphocytes, the name comes because they mature in the bone marrow. Stems of the bone marrow transport in the liver, and from the liver, they come into the bone marrow. They mature, they process in the bone marrow. That's why the name is given as the B lymphocytes and B cells. So what are the main characteristics, or you can say the feat of the B lymphocytes? These cells give rise to the plasma cells, which in turn form a certain protein molecules called antibodies and pass into the body fluid and circulate into the body. So whenever there will be an infection, the B lymphocytes will give rise to the plasma cell. Plasma cells will come out in the form of a protein chemical, that is your antibodies, and they will circulate in the body fluid. So B lymphocytes will circulate in the body fluid, that is in the blood and the lymph. B lymphocytes develop humoral or antibody mediated immunity, because that means the body fluid. So the action of the B lymphocytes will take place in the body fluids only, and these are formed in response to some antigenic infection. So B lymphocytes are being formed only when some infection will be there in our body, or there will be the attack of antigen. Next is your T lymphocytes or T cells. Those stem cells of bone marrow which are transported to the thymus, that is again the one of your lymph gland, and they mature over there. So the name is given as the T lymphocytes or the T cells. And these cells form the active T lymphocytes. So B cells, they form the plasma cells and the antibodies, but these will form the active T cells and they will attack itself, which form a cellular or the cell-mediated immunity, because they are going to target the cells which are going to be get infected. So that's why they are having, or they are against the working of the cells. After maturation, these cells get differentiated into two groups, that is T lymphocytes. Number one is cytotoxic or the killer T cells, means which kill the specific cells by the variety of mechanism that we will be discussed in our higher classes. Helper T cells, which activates the specific B cells to produce the antibodies. T lymphocytes are responsible for the graft rejection or the transplant. So there are two types of the T cell, that is the cytotoxic, jo cell mein jaake cell ke upar target organ ko khatam karega. इसका दूसरा नाम है किलर टी सेल्स, और हेल्पर जो कि बी लिम्फोसाइट्स को हेल्प करेगा प्लाज्मा सेल बनाने में और एंटीबॉडीज बनाने में. यू कैन सी इन दिस पर्टिकुलर इमेज स्टेम सेल्स ऑफ द बोन मैरो, एंड आफ्टर द बर्थ इफ दे विल कम टू द बोन मैरो मैच्योर ओवर देयर, एंड देन दे विल फॉर्म अ बी सेल्स, and if they will be transported to the thymus gland and they will be processed there, they will be multiplied there, then the cells are being called as the T lymphocytes. And then they will form our B cells, they will form our plasma cells, and the plasma cells will form the antibodies and which make our body free from the infection. So in this image you can see that how the B and T cells are being formed and what is the difference between the B and the T cells. Next is your types of acquired immunity. So there are two types of acquired immunity. One is active and another is passive. Active immunity. It is developed due to contact with pathogen, dead or living, or its antigen that leads to production of antibodies in the host body. What is the meaning of that active immunity? कि जब भी आपकी body पे या किसी लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म की बॉडी पे कोई पैथोजन चाहे लिविंग है या नॉन लिविंग है मींस डेड है अटैक करता है तो बॉडी उस अटैक के अगेंस्ट उसे एंटीजन मान के बॉडी में एंटीबॉडीज की प्रोडक्शन शुरू हो जाती है सो द फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द एंटीबॉडीज अगेंस्ट द पैथोजन और द एंटीजन that leads into the host body, that immunity is known as active immunity. It has no or only the side effects and that side effects are not being known to us. It is a slow but a long lasting. Means once the body has produced the antibodies against any of the antigen, then it will be for lifelong. For example, if you are suffering from chickenpox, और एक बार अगर आपको चिकन पॉक्स हो गया जिस वायरस के कारण हुआ उसके अगेंस्ट हमारी बॉडी ने एंटीबॉडीज बना लिया और बॉडी को चिकन पॉक्स से फ्री कर दिया तो लाइफ में कभी भी दोबारा से चिकन पॉक्स नहीं होगा सो इम्यूनिटी डिवेल्प ड्यूरिंग द नेचुरल इन्फेक्शन और द अटैक ऑफ द एंटीजन दैट टाइप ऑफ एक्टिव इम्यूनिटी इज नोन एज नेचुरल इम्यूनिटी कि बॉडी ने नेचुरल अटैक ऑफ द एंटीजन के अगेंस्ट एंटीबॉडीज बनाई और अपनी बॉडी को फॉर एवर फ्री कर दिया फ्रॉम द अटैक ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर एंटीजन फॉर एग्जाम्पल इज चिकन पॉक्स मीजल स्मॉल पॉक्स एंड सो ऑन And in the second one, that is artificial. This involves the intentional introduction of some antigen, usually they are dead, to produce the antibodies against it. For example, vaccination. जैसे कि आजकल बहुत सारी बीमारियों की vaccinations हैं, polio की vaccination है, chicken pox की भी है हमारे पास, typhoid की भी है, tuberculosis की भी है कि हम जानबूझकर बच्चे के अंदर इंजेक्शन लगाते हैं एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर इंजेक्शन कंसिस्ट ऑफ वीक और अ डेड एंटीजन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर डिजीज एंड आफ्टर दैट द बॉडी विल डिवेलप द एंटीबॉडीज अगेंस्ट इट एंड आवर बॉडी बिकम इम्यून टू दैट पर्टिकुलर डिजीज जैसे कहते हैं पोलियो के दो बूंद उस दो बूंद में डेड पोलियो वायरस इज देयर विच इज गोइंग टू गिव टू द चाइल्ड And the child will develop antibodies against that particular antigen. And for after that, it is for lifelong. If the same virus in the natural form, if attack the body is not going to have the that particular disease because body is already have the production of antibodies against that particular virus or antigen or any other pathogen. So what is active immunity का मतलब है कि जब बॉडी में किसी पैथोजन ने अटैक किया उस पैथोजन के अगेंस्ट बॉडी ने एंटीबॉडीज बनाई और वो एंटीबॉडीज उसकी बॉडी में हमेशा रहेंगी और दोबारा से उसके अटैक से हमारी बॉडी को वो डिजीज नहीं होगी अगर एक बार हुई और तब हमने एंटीबॉडीज बनाई तो उसे कहेंगे नेचुरल एक्टिव इम्यूनिटी पर होने से पहले ही हमने अगर अपनी बॉडी को उससे इम्यून कर लिया प्रिवेंट कर लिया उसे हम कहेंगे आर्टिफिशियल एक्टिव इम्यूनिटी Is it clear? So it takes time to develop its response, but it is long lasting. Is it clear? Chali, next is your passive immunity. So it is developed when ready-made antibodies are injected into the body to protect the body against the foreign agents or infections. So what is the meaning of passive immunity? Ka matlab hai ki agar hamari body mein koi pathogen ya koi foreign agent ya koi infection hota hai aur hame apni body ko immediately usse protect karna hai to ready-made antibodies inject ki jati hai. For example, agar aapko kisi animal ne kaata, jaise dog ne kaat liya, snake ne kaat liya, तो हमें इमीडिएटली उसकी प्रिवेंशन करनी है, उसकी ट्रीटमेंट करनी है, तो हम एंटी स्नेक वेनम या एंटी रेबीज का इंजेक्शन लगाते हैं. उस पर्टिकुलर इंजेक्शन में रेडीमेड एंटीबॉडीज होती हैं, जिससे कि इमीडिएटली ट्रीटमेंट मिल जाती है और हम उस पर्टिकुलर पेशेंट को बचा लेते हैं विद द हेल्प ऑफ द रेडीमेड एंटीबॉडीज. सो इट मे कॉज द रिएक्शन, क्योंकि वो एंटीबॉडीज हैं, वो प्रोटीन्स हैं, हो सकता है कि किसी को रिएक्शन करे, बट इट इज वेरी रेयर. इट इज फास्ट, जैसे ही लगाया उसने अपना काम शुरू कर देना है और उसकी ट्रीटमेंट स्टार्ट हो जाएगी. लास्ट फॉर फ्यू डेज ओनली, मतलब इट इज नॉट लॉन्ग लास्टिंग, इट इज नॉट फॉर एवर. दोबारा से अगर डॉग ने काटा या दोबारा से स्नेक ने काटा, तो दोबारा से एंटी रेबिस या एंटी स्नेक वेनम का इंजेक्शन लगवाना पड़ेगा. ये नहीं है कि मुझे एक बार लग चुका है और अब मुझे दोबारा लगाने की जरूरत नहीं है. इट इज नॉट फॉर दैट, इट इज जस्ट फॉर फ्यू डेज ओनली, जैसे कि 2 महीने के लिए, 6 महीने के लिए. पर यू हैव टू गो रिपीटेडली इफ द सेम पर्टिकुलर problem arises. So it is used when the immune response has to be faster. ये भी दो तरह का है. One is your natural and artificial. Natural है जैसे कि infants को हम कहते हैं colostrum, मतलब mother's milk. And it contains the various antibodies. It contains the various, you can say the resistance against the diseases, but only for few days only. That is for 1 or 2 months. And artificial, that is about the tetanus antitoxin. सुना होगा, tetanus का injection जरूर लगवा लो अगर आप कहीं गिरे हैं, हो सकता है आपको infection ना हो जाए. Anti rabies against any of the animal. Anti snake venom, that is against the bite of the snake. So passive immunity is having the ready made antibodies to give the immediate response, to give the fast response, but it is only for the few days. Whereas active immunity is the production of antibodies by the body itself. It is slow but lasts long. So this is a major difference between the active immunity and the passive immunity. The next is our components of immune system. So working of immune system is based on 2 components. Jo immune body hai, hamari immune system hai, it works on 2 components. One is humoral or antibodies mediated immune system, and the second is cell mediated immune system. So first we are having the humoral or antibodies mediated immune system. So here we are going to discuss when any infection takes place in our body fluids. If the antigen or the pathogen attack our blood and plasma or lymph, then how the body will make the body free from the disease, or how the immunity is going to be developed. So if the, you can say the infection takes place in the blood, plasma or the lymph, then the B lymphocytes will come into the action. They will produce plasma cells. Plasma cells will produce the antibodies, and that antibodies are very very specific for a particular antigen. Agar bacteria ne attack kiya hai to bacteria ke against antibodies banengi, virus ne attack kiya hai to virus ke against antibodies banengi. They are very specific for the specific pathogen, and this particular B lymphocytes will work only when there is an infection or attack to the body fluids. So It consists of different types of antibodies that occur in the body humors or the body fluids like lymph and blood plasma. The antibodies are formed by the plasma cells, which in turn are produced by the B lymphocytes. The cells are able to produce antibodies specific for each type of the antigen. So that AMI means antibody mediated immunity occur against the pathogen that enter the body fluid. So they are very specific in their action, and B lymphocytes will produce plasma cells. Plasma cells will produce the antibodies, and that antibodies are specific for each type of the antigen. And that will work only when the attack will be on the body fluids like lymph and blood plasma. Next is our cell mediated immunity. Now, this particular immunity, when the attack will be on the body cell or tissues. So it is a component of immune system which consists of T lymphocytes. So when there is an attack to our cell or tissues, then T lymphocytes will come into the action. CMI means cell mediated immunity function against the pathogen which pass into the host cell. अगर इन्फेक्शन आपके होस्ट सेल में, मतलब सेल के अंदर चली जाती है, टिश्यूज में जाती है, तो टी लिम्फोसाइट्स जो है वो डायरेक्टली वहां जाके उस पर्टिकुलर एंटीजन को या पैथोजन को इनएक्टिवेट करेंगे. द इम्यून सिस्टम आल्सो ऑपरेट अगेंस्ट द कैंसर सेल्स एंड ट्रांसप्लांट. ट्रांसप्लांट्स का मतलब है, जैसे आपने सुना होगा कि किडनी ट्रांसप्लांट करनी है या स्किन ग्राफ्टिंग करेंगे, पर उससे पहले हमें अपनी बॉडी का इम्यून सिस्टम सप्रेस करना होता है. द रीजन इज कि दैट पर्टिकुलर ट्रांसप्लांट, जैसे किडनी हमने किसी से ली, तो बॉडी के लिए वो किडनी क्या है, फॉरेन पार्टिकल, एंटीजन है, तो वो उसे एक्सेप्ट नहीं करने देगा. कौन नहीं करने देगा? सेल मेडिएटेड इम्यून सिस्टम. सो वी हैव टू मेक अवर बॉडी इम्यून सिस्टम सप्रेस इफ देयर शुड बी अ ट्रांसप्लांट और अ स्किन ग्राफ्टिंग और एनी अदर टाइप ऑफ ए ग्राफ्टिंग. इट ऑल्सो एक्टिवेट्स अ बी लिम्फोसाइट्स सो दैट दे कैन प्रोड्यूस द एंटीबॉडीज एंड प्रोटेक्ट अवर बॉडी फ्रॉम द इन्फेक्शन. सो वॉट वी हैव डिस्कस टूडे, तो वी हैव डिस्कस द सेल ऑफ इम्यून सिस्टम जो सारे इम्यून सिस्टम में हेल्प करेंगे फॉर द प्रोडक्शन ऑफ एंटीबॉडीज, दैट इज योर बी लिम्फोसाइट्स एंड टी लिम्फोसाइट. व्हाई दे आर द बी लिम्फोसाइट्स? बिकॉज दे मैच्योर्ड एंड प्रोसेस इन द बोन मैरो. एंड व्हाई दे आर कॉल्ड एज द टी लिम्फोसाइट्स? बिकॉज दे आर बींग प्रोसेस्ड एंड मैच्योर्ड इन द थाइमस ग्लैंड. And after that, we are having a two types of acquired immunity. One is active and one is passive. Active immunity, that is being in which the production of antibodies will takes place by the body itself after the attack of the pathogen or the antigen. And it is for last long life, you can say. It is of two type, that is your natural and artificial. Passive immunity, in which the ready-made antibodies are being introduced into the host cell whenever they get attacked by the antigen or any of the foreign agent. So this is not for last long, it is for only for the few days, and we have to repeat that particular process if again they are being infected by the same particular foreign agent. Now the components on which the immune system work, that is your antibodies mediated immune system, which works with the body fluids, that is your blood plasma and the lymph, and the cell which come into the action, that is your B lymphocytes. And cell mediated immune system, which consists of T lymphocytes, and against the pathogen which pass into the host cell. So whenever there is an attack to the body fluids, then the action comes by the B lymphocytes. And when there is an attack to your cell or the tissues, then T lymphocytes will come into the action. And function of both of them to make your body free from the infection by the production of antibodies or by engulfing that particular pathogen or a foreign particle. Our next lesson will be on lymphoid organs. Till then, stay safe, stay healthy, stay home. Goodbye. Thank you.